everyone. My name's Ruth. I volunteer at the Bluebell Railway. You know, I find myself at home with rather a lot of time on my hands at the moment, so I've been doing lots of reading. Only problem is, I've nearly finished my spring edition of Footplate, the Stepney Club magazine, so I've had to look around for something else to read. And I found this. Crossing Time on the Blueberry Line. This is a rather special book. It's written by a friend of mine, Simon Hall, and it's got some magical illustrations by Cameron Bennett and David Charlesworth. I thought I'd share some of it with you now. I'll tell you a secret. I particularly like this story because it's about, it features an engine called Blackmore Vale. Blackmore Vale is a rather special big engine. And do you know where Blackmore Vale lives? Yeah, you got it. He lives at the Bluebell Railway. Ready? I'll begin. Chapter 1, Steaming Through Time. Once upon a time, at the very beginning of time, there was a place where horses grazed, living on what was then a unicorn farm. It was a special place, a mythical place, now known as the quiet village of Horsefield. The Blueberry Steam Railway line runs nearby, winding its quiet way from Hourglass Park to the sleepy villages of Queenscote and East Minutelate. But as the line reaches Horsefield station, something wonderful, something quite magical happens. It passes across the meridian, a line of both time and distance that crosses the world from top to bottom, setting out where east meets west. The meridian is fixed, an edge to space and time that neither moves forwards nor backwards. It is never wise to be late or impatient on the Blueberry Line, as time does indeed stand still in a space and an era born many, many years ago. So, if you rush, strange things can start to happen, as Dad would find out that summer half-term day. Tom, Holly, and their parents had left their house in the woods, but for a change had decided to bring Pip the cat too. Pip had white paws, a white chest, and a suit of black shiny fur. Always sensible and always quiet, she slept unbothered in the back of the car. "Oh, my life!" shouted Dad as he looked at his watch. "It's 9:15 and the train leaves at 9:30. We're going to be late. We'll miss the train." "Calm down, dear," Mum replied. "It's only a steam train ride." Dad put his foot down and overtook a red tractor with a not-so-bothered farmer chewing contentedly on a straw of barley. Tom and Holly closed their eyes tightly as Dad swerved up to Hourglass Park station entrance. "Quick as you can, jump out and be smart," panted Dad. "I'll park the car, and if you buy the tickets, Mum," he trailed off as a whistle cut through the spring air. "Run, or we'll miss the train," Dad pleaded. As Holly stepped out of the car and picked a tiny, tiny blueberry growing nearby and lifted it to the nose of her toy unicorn. "It's lovely," she sighed, not wishing to be rushed or hurried. "This is Peggy," she said solemnly to the tiny fruit, before turning to the unicorn and adding, "It's a blueberry." Dad sped off in a cloud of dust to park the car, leaving Pip, Tom, Holly and Mum standing in front of a fine-looking red brick Victorian building with coloured stained glass and a pointed spired roof. Pip looked up at the top of the building and its red-tiled roof, wondering what fun it would be to climb up there on such a sunny day. "Perhaps a little too hot on the paws," she reconsidered. Instead, she followed Mum into the cool station as Tom and Holly walked through onto the platform. It was very quiet for a Friday in summer half-term, thought Tom, as he noticed that there was no one else on the platform except station staff, all dressed smartly with polished cap badges, brass buttons, starched collars and bright red ties.
"Platform 2 on the other side of the track," said the ticket man. "The first train of the day is a very special train."
"A special train?" queried Mum, raising an eyebrow in alarm.
"Yes, it's number 21C123, Blackmore Vale, designed by the famous Oliver Bullard, one of only 66 West Country locomotives that were built between 1945 and 1951.
"Oh, fascinating," said Mum, trying to look interested, but really wondering what might be worth watching on the TV that night.
"It's particularly special because the train leaves in 10 minutes and crosses the meridian this morning," whispered the ticket man.
"Not in a rush today, are you?" he smiled.
"It's never a good thing to be late or in a rush on the Blueberry Line, as strange things can start to happen."
And we'll find out what strange things start to happen in the next instalment, which will be read by my friend Simon Hall, who wrote the book. Now, don't worry, because in the meantime, there are lots of games and activities, including details of how to join the Stepney Club, on the children's section of our website at bluebell-railway.com. And there are plenty of children's books, in fact, this one included, and puzzles in our online shop. So go to bluebell-railway.com and search for shop. In the meantime, keep your eyes peeled for the next instalment. Bye, everyone.